One day, I was in my house many years ago, long time. And I just took my bath in the morning. I sat, I was studying the scripture. And the Lord showed me one of our brothers in church. The Lord said, if you want to meet him alive, go to his house now. Run. Now, it's quite a distance. I didn't drive. I took bike. I told him, I said, just be going, be going. As I was entering, now I'm not telling you Nollywood movie or Hollywood, not be film. Koro koro, see me. See. As he was about to put a piece of meat in his mouth, I dived and I tapped his hand. I opened the door and I jumped, tapped his hand. It fell. Right before me, it started moving. Meat, meat, meat. M-E-A-T. It was about, as I hit his hand, it fell. It started moving. It was moving. Bam! We could not find it anymore. Now, he was dating a woman. He didn't get wife. Oh. He don't drive wife, come out. Wife now, witch. He don't call wife, witch. Come out. He was dating a woman. Now, he ran. I said, who gave you this food? He said, we ran to the woman's room. We didn't find her. We didn't find her clothes. We didn't find her box. We didn't find her jewelries. We didn't find nothing. Till today, we didn't find her. I pity you if you are not spiritual. Romans 8 verse 9. He that has not the spirit of God is not of him. If in this era, when destinies are being wasted, you still go to club, I pity you. In this era, where destinies are being ruined, you are still smoking. I pity you. Continue. I didn't say change you. I said continue. In Revelation, he said, he that steal, let him steal on. He that is wicked, let him be wicked. You will see what will make you run from wickedness.